The fact is that the compromise that was reached involved a lot of tough choices, as we've discussed and as the president has discussed. Not everyone got what he or she wanted. The president did not get everything he wanted. He would not have supported this, does not support the provision that concerns the mayor. And he is a firm supporter of D.C. home rule. But in a negotiation, you have to make tough choices, and he fought hard to and succeeded in preventing a strenuous effort by the Republicans to defund Planned Parenthood, to defund access to women's health providers and around the country, and felt that that was vitally important and made sure that that was preserved. What is not appropriate, given the consequences and the stakes, is to hold a positive vote on raising the debt ceiling hostage to something else, because a game of chicken with our economy is a hugely risky affair that will not just be a game of who wins and who loses in the political sweepstakes here in Washington, but will have a catastrophic and direct impact on economies around the world and on Americans here, you know, on their savings, on their interest rates, on their jobs, and on their prospects. So this is simply not something we can mess around with. We are urging this that this be taken up and addressed in a timely fashion, because, as you say, it is risky business to play chicken with the economy, and playing chicken would include going up to the last minute, which creates a lot of uncertainty for the global economy, on a scale that makes last week look like something very small and local. So, in terms of the negotiations we're having, I don't have any details for you on that, except that I would again point you to the fact that every single leader in Congress of both parties has made clear that this will pass, and that not to pass it would be sheer folly. We take them at their word.